me earlier before we started this. I was saying how, like, I've actually tweeted you before several times.
I'm sorry.
Yeah, you've never responded to any of my very lovely things I say about you off and on the court.
What had happened was I was probably on air when you tweeted, so I probably missed it. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, sure. That's what it was. You was on air. But that's besides the point. You are here with me now, and I get more time with you. This is in person. It's even better.
Okay.
So you are number one draft pick. Your younger sister, she just got drafted, right?
Mm-hmm.
So, did your parents play basketball?
Nah, they African. You know what I'm saying? No, they didn't really know much about sports. They were passionate about, like, all things. They mm-hmm. both came to the States for education. They had planned to go back to Nigeria to run their family businesses, but instead, you know, the fairy tale, they fall in love. My dad gets a job in Houston, Texas. My mom pops out four girls. And the rest was kind of history, but nah, my parents did not think that basketball was gonna be the answer. If you know us Africans, you know what's the answer? School, studying, them books, that homework.
Right.
And so it was just really, literally it was like luck of chance that we fell into basketball. Our first sport was gymnastics.
Wow. So wait, so who kicked it off then? Like, for real?
We were four girls in one house. Mm-hmm. My dad, his business is international, so he'd always be traveling for business, but he'd come home for like every holiday, every birthday, every major event, all that type of stuff. And so, four girls in one house, we had all our grades, you know, done and well. And eventually, my mom was like, yo, these women are tiring me out. These young women are tiring me out. They did their homework, they're great girls, but they're playing. Let me put them into some kind of activity. Mm. Well, our neighborhood was right next to a gymnastics gym. So she's like, all right, let me just throw them in there. I will tell you this, okay? I knew I was never destined for greatness in gymnastics. You know those uneven bars?
Right.
I was on there and I'm like, why am I, I'm watching all these girls flying around. I'm like, why am I never getting around? That's because my legs were so long, my butt was hitting the floor, and I never had enough traction to get around. I was like, why can't I never get through? And so my mom was just standing there like, thank you, they're tired now, and then I'll bring them home and give them dinner and all that type of stuff. One day my mom's coworker comes, and she's like looking like, why do you have your girls in gymnastics? Your girls are tall, you see their long legs, they're all gangly and stuff, put them in basketball. Mm. So when I was 9 years old, my sister was 10, we had our first basketball practice, and I will tell you, we were trash. So we had our first basketball practice, and I'll tell you what we were wearing. We pulled up, and this is where I say our parents didn't know much about sports. Jean shorts.
Oh, wow.
Halter top, glasses holder. And you know, all the girls were wearing cool Adidas, cool Nikes. We were wearing Keds. And back then, the only people that wore Keds were like pretty much like the nurses and stuff with their socks.
Y'all wore Keds on a basketball court?
Neck and I were like, this is a whole new world. Like, what's going on here? And so we went out there, and NECA, her first shot, I always say, like, didn't go over the backboard. It went over the shot clock on top of the backboard. And I was there. I'm the type of person, I'm so competitive. I only do things that I know I'm really good at.
Right.
And so I was like, all right, I need to go to the bathroom real quick. Stayed in the bathroom that whole practice. My sister went out there, embarrassed herself, but she was curious. And so, you know, that first year, NECA went through being the worst player on the team. But every night she'd come home and show me on the driveway, all right, this is a crossover. This is how I do it. This is a free throw. This is how you hold your follow through. And so the next year, I already had the basics, and then I started playing too.
Yo, this is a movie.
I mean,
has anybody talked about doing a movie about?
Hey guys!
That's amazing, especially like, oh, y'all went home and just started practicing, but mm-hmm. did y'all get better really fast?
Oh my gosh, yes. So the way we got better is actually really interesting. So NECA was playing that first year and she was not the best. So it was so bad that my dad was trying to find creative ways for her to be good. So he's like, all right, at this point, I will give you $1 for every rebound you get.
Wow.
And so slowly but surely, like after maybe a few months, she was collecting a lot of money. And so the wheels started going and then she just wanted every rebound and wanted to make every shot. And then I'm watching her and I'm like, shoot, I want to be lit like my sister too. You know what I mean? She had 20, I was like, I want 20, you know? And so we tag teamed, but that's how we sort of started like those engines going for us to be great.